Dear student, today we will discuss how to draw ERD or Entity Relationship Diagrams using Microsoft Visio. We will discuss one case study. So for that one, here we have a case study. But first of all, we have to open the Microsoft Visio. So in search option, Visio 2016. In Microsoft Visio 2016, we have to click it over here on the basic diagrams, or we can directly click it over here on the database. And in database, we are having the different type of notations are available. First one, we are having the cross functions, cross footed notations. And here we are having the chain notation. We discussed the two main important notation, cross footed notations and chain notation. Now first we will try the cross foot database notation. So click it over here, cross foot database notations, and then click it over here, create. When we click it over here, it will display some basics component of this one, that is a primary attribute, primary key separator, entity attribute and relationship. Let's see, first move to the case study. What is the case study is here? So for case study, let me open it in the Microsoft Word, that will be more clear. What we have here, it says that a supplier may supply many items. First one is here from this one, that is a supplier. It means we will have an entity, the name of that one entity is a supplier. And second one, that supplier supply the items. So another entity, that is a item. Now when we see that may, supplier may supply items, may means that supplier may not supply any items or may supply many items. It may be possible that we are having supplier who didn't supply any items, or we have a supplier who supply the many items. So first one entity over here, we say that we are having the, that is the supplier, and second one we are having the items. So we have to draw the two different entity in Microsoft Visio. How? Here we are having the entity component of cross-footed database notation is here. Just click it over here, drag it and drop it over here on this sheet. Now move it above. Okay, now here we have to write the entity name. Double click it over here. So entity name should be, what we say, we are having the name of entity supplier. The name of entity must be in uppercase letters. Currently we are not using any attribute, just we are mentioning the name of entity type. Let's then we will discuss how attribute can be added. Second one, first we see that we are having the different entity types are available. First one is a supplier. Second one entity, we are having the concept of items. Now what we have, second entity is here item, drag it and drop it over here. Now mention it over here, items, anywhere we can drop it. So remove these attribute names from the entity. Okay, now what we say again, I'm moving, supplier may supply many items. we are having the supplier, let's supply the many items. Now we have to use the relationships. Click it over here, drag it. Now we have to use it over here, move it to the supplier, and then second one we have to move it over here on the items. So what we have here, if we check cardinality is here, it's mean that currently what we it show supplier supply one and only one item. No, according to the description, supplier may supply many items. May it mean that supplier is not supplying any items. So what we have to click it over here on the name of the relationship or line that is used to represent the relationship, right click, and then click it over here, set begin samples. What should be, we see that suppliers may supply many items, that is the end symbol. So that is supplier may supply either zero or many items. So here now it display the cardinality. Here it see the cardinality is here. We are having the zero or many. Minimum cardinality is here zero, supplier may supply. So minimum cardinality is zero, many items, so that will be considered the maximum cardinality, right? And second one, next one, if we check what it say in description, it say each item is supplied by any number of supplier. When we see that each item is supplied by any number of supplier, so if we have items that is supplied by, is supplied mean at least one supplier is there. So for that one, right click again, click on the relation, right click, and then set as a begin symbol. So that should be over here, at least we are having the one, and it may be possible that we are having the many suppliers, right? So here minimum cardinality is one and maximum cardinality is many. So participation of this one entity type is mandatory, while whenever minimum cardinality is zero, participation of this one entity type is optional. Now when it's done, now one more thing we have to do, what we have to use the name of the relationship. The name of relationship, we say supplier supplies. Supplier supply many items, right? So when we say that supplier supply many items, or item are supplied by many suppliers, so we can use it over here, supply relationship over here. Or if we are not using it over here, just click remove it, press the delete, select it and delete it, and now we can add it over here, like text box, click and use it over here. We say supplier supplies, relationship name starts with the uppercase letter. So it's a move over here, let's move it anywhere we can place, just this one is the perfect. Supplier supplies zero or many items, and what item are supplied by. So again we need another, so for that one we see that we have to use this one, supplied by item or supplied by, item is supplied by one or many suppliers. Item is supplied by many supplier. Is supplied by means at least minimum participation of the this one entry type is mandatory, while here the minimum participation is optional. That is the first point. Now next, item may be used in the assembly of at least one product. If we are having items are there, item must be used in the assembly of, used in assembly of at least one product. So here we are using the word at least. At least it's mean that we are having at least minimum cardinality is 1. 1 products. So what we have another entity that we want to use it over here, that is product. Right? Now we have to create the relationship between the item and product. So how? Let's draw it. Another entity that is the product. So this one entity type name should be a product. So write it over here, the name of the entity type. The name is here product. The name of entity type again, that must be in uppercase letters. Remove it. Okay, now what we have relationship, drag it and drop it. We are having the two different entities are involved, this one and this one. Okay, now what we have, right click it over here. What should be, we see that item, just check it. Item must be supplied in the assembly of at least one item and may be used in many product. At least one, minimum cardinality is 1 for the product, while maximum cardinality can be here many. Right? Minimum is 1 and maximum is many. How we can use it? Click on the relationship name, right click, set as a beginning. So end symbol is here. What should be? We see that minimum cardinality should be here 1 and maximum should be 1 or more. So here it select the minimum cardinality that is 1 and maximum cardinality that is a many. So participation of this one entity is mandatory. Now second, from what about the product and relationship? When we see that we are having the product is available, conversely each product must use one or more items. So here it says each product contains one or more items, must use one or more item. So here again minimum cardinality is 1, maximum cardinality is many. Right click, so start symbol is here, minimum cardinality is 1, maximum is many. So here participation of both of these entity type is mandatory. No one entity is involved in the relationship having the optional participations. So here mandatory 1, this one is mandatory many. This one is a mandatory many, and this one is again mandatory many. What should be the name of relationship? So here we said it's items use in products. Item use in product. So again we have to use it over here in the text box. Item use in product. What about this one? Product uses different items. So another relationship should be here. Item uses items. One items or many items. Because of this relationship. Boot up. We can set the size, what else we can move the and take like this. Now let's see the third point. Supplier may send many shipment. Now supplier is already available, may send many shipments. May, it's may supplier send zero, or may send many, right? May send many shipments. So new entry type should be here, so that is a shipment. So here we have to use the supplier is already available, so we have to use another entry type, that is a name of entry type should be here. We say that's a shipment. Okay, so relationship between this one with this. Okay, now supplier entry type name should be here, shipment. Supplier may supply many shipment. So here we are having the end symbol should be may, so zero or more. Supplier may supplier may send the many shipment. While what about others? It said that each shipment must be sent by exactly one supplier. Exactly one supplier must be sent by exactly one supplier. If there is any shipment that is supplied by exactly one supplier. So it means minimum cardinality is 1 and maximum cardinality is also 1. So right click it over here. And then we are having the begin symbol, that is one and only one. So what we say, supplier may send many shipments, while each shipment is sent by exactly one supplier, or one and only one supplier. So we said it, what should be a relationship here? So name of relationship, we have to write it over here, text box. The name of relationship is here, supplier sends 0, supplier sends 0 or many shipments, while each shipment is sent by each shipment is sent by exactly one supplier. Now shipment, another shipment must include one or more items. Now shipment is already available and item entity is already we have, so we don't need to draw again the same entity. The name of entity type must be distinct within organization. So shipment must include one are more items. So minimum cardinality is relationship between the shipment and items. Just draw relationship. So here the item is here, and here we are having the item. If you want to drag it down, we can move it. No issue. So what it say? It says that shipment must include one or more items. So by default, where here we are in shipment must include zero or many items. So that must be one or more items. So end symbol, sorry, we are having the starting symbol, that is one or more items. Shipment must include one or more items. What about second one? Item may be included on several shipments. May be included means maybe. It's mean that is optional, that may we are having the minimum cardinality can be zero on several mean many. So shipment, the relationship between here we are having the minimum cardinality item and shipment, that is a zero or many. So how? So we say that we are having right click, set end symbols, and that is a zero or more. We see item according to the description, shipment must include one or more items, and item may be included on the several shipments. So item includes, shipments includes items. So the name of relationship must be here, inserted text box, and here includes. And what we have, items included on shipments, items included on shipment, drag it, click it. Items included on. Item included on shipments. Now next point that we say, customer may submit any number of the orders. So previously we don't have the customer entity and order entity, so we have to draw the two new entity type. The first one is a customer, second one is a order. So customer is here, we have to draw it customer entity type. Let me, entry type is here, we have to use it over here. The name of entry type is here, we see that customer. Attribute names, at this stage we are not using any attribute names. And second one, entry type is here, that is next one, entry type is here, order. So two different entry types are available. Here the relationship between the customers and order is, customer may submit any number of orders. May means zero order, or any number of one order, or many orders. Customer may submit zero, one, or many orders. So here relationship between the customers and order is, we say that we are having the minimum cardinality should be here 0 and maximum cardinality can be any. So what we have, customer may submit 0 or any number of orders, may submit any number of orders, so that can be 0, 1 or many. Minimum cardinality should be here 0 and maximum cardinality is here 1. We already have minimum cardinality 0 and maximum cardinality many. While each order is submitted by, each order must be submitted by exactly one customer. Order is submitted by exactly one customer. It means one order is there, that is submitted by one and only one customer. So minimum cardinality should be here 1 and maximum cardinality is here 1. So participation of customer entity type is mandatory. So we see that this one is mandatory one and this one is optional many. Now the name of relationship be, we see that customer submit the orders. So what we have to do, we have to insert the name of relation. So what we have, customers submits, customer submits orders, while orders are submitted by customers. So next one, entity type is here, drag it, text box. Submitted by, order are submitted by customers. Now, what else? Order must request one or more product. And each order, we are having one product or many product. Product order entity is already, we already draw it. And product entity, we already have product entity. So we have to just draw the relationship between the order and product. Order must request one or more product. So relationship between order and product, we have to use it over here. Drag and drop it. So we say we are having the end symbol, what have the one or more product, must include one or more products. And second one, we say that a given product may not be requested any order. It may be possible that we are having the order, product is available for that one, no one request, or may be requested on one or more orders. One product is there, for that one we may have zero order, one order, or many orders. So for that one, so we are having the, for each product we are having zero or many orders are there, that is already drawn over here. So participation of this one is optional many, this one that is the optional, this one is a mandatory many. So it means participation of this one is a mandatory, this one is mandatory many, this one is optional many. Here we are having the mandatory many. Now here we are having the mandatory one. This one is a optional many. This one contains, we are having the optional many. Now what we have to mention the name of relationships. Sorry, this one is moved. Okay, now the what should be the name of orders? Request for one or many products. Each order request. Each order request. So just let me make it smaller so that it shouldn't disturb the other. Okay, now the one for each product requested and different orders requested on to draw it. Fine, it's all about this one ERD, and this one ERD we say that we are having the different entities are there having the relationship among those entities, and we discuss about their cardinality among these entity types. We say that's how we may be able to assign the name of relationship. Thanks for watching the video.